Building automation systems allow a facility to have centralized and automatic control of HVAC and other systems. Control Basic is the coding process that creates this automation flexibility in our controllers running these systems. Previously, we looked at the process of how controllers execute Control Basic programs. In this video, we're going to look at mnemonic versus names, setting variables, conditional statements, using comparisons such as greater than, less than, or equal to, and finally, commenting our code using REM statements. When working in Control Basic, point references can be made using either mnemonics such as BO1 or AO7, or point names such as fan or valve position. In our example, we will be using mnemonic variables as they can be easily traced back to the controller objects. They can also make your program shorter. Let's look at our first example of a simple Control Basic program. Open a new program. Here we're going to control a fan and modulate a valve based on whether or not the fan is running. If the fan is running, we want the valve to be at 25%. The fan is controlled by BO1 and the valve is driven by AO7. Our first statement will read, if BO1 equals 1, then AO7 equals 25. In this case, if BO1 is on, then AO7 will modulate to 25%. Compile or run the program to see if it works correctly. A great way to know if your code is compiled correctly is to look in the output window. This window will allow you to see any errors that have occurred. One thing to note, when you compile the program, it tests for proper syntax. When you run the program, it will compile the program, save the program to the controller, and then run the program. Now, while we see the statement works for opening the valve, we have no code here to change the modulation of the valve. It will remain at 25 even if our fan shuts off. We must add another piece to our statement to change our valve position when the fan turns off. Let's add an else, AO7 equals 5, to the end of our code. Now our code is going to read, if BO1 equals 1, then AO7 equals 25. Else, AO7 equals 5. The else syntax is saying if BO1 is not equal 1, meaning the fan is off, change our valve position to 5. Again, compile or run the program to make sure there are no errors. If you do have an error, you will see a red circle with an X. Check your new section of code for these syntax errors. The code will now modulate the valve back and forth to these values based on the value of the binary input. Conditional statements, including if, then, and else logic, will be used for a lot of your coding work, so be sure to be comfortable with these statements. Now we're going to look at making basic comparisons using greater than and less than operators. Let's compare an analog input range and set another analog value based on it. Our first statement will read, if analog input 10 is greater than 15, then binary output 1 equals 1. Our second line of code will read, if analog input 10 is less than 5, then binary output 1 equals 0. These two lines of code work together. If analog input 10 is greater than 15, binary output 1 will be set to 1, or it will be started. Once analog input 10 falls to less than 5, then binary output 1 will be set to 0, or stopped. In this example, we could have written our code using the start or stop commands to manipulate BO1. Make sure to compile your code after each new section of code is written to make sure you're on the right track and to minimize any time spent looking for errors. This will get you into a good habit of checking your work. The last thing we want to look at is commenting your code. This best practice is highly valuable and can keep your code organized and allow for others to quickly understand what the code is doing. Comments are written using a REM statement, where REM stands for remark. Now, let's look at commenting our code with a REM statement. We are going to add comments to our code. Start by typing REM. Notice it will turn green and all the text following will also be green. This indicates to the controller that the text is a comment and can be ignored for execution. In this example, we will add program name, when we created it, who created it, and a version number. Now, let's create one more REM statement to our specific section of code. This basic statement will allow anyone else to quickly understand the code without a whole lot of investigation. For more information on Control Basic and point passing, check out the other videos in this series. Or, to learn more about any of the solutions from the Building Geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.